Right, so in this video, I'm gonna show you how to create this original Lion King poster. This is the version after Photoshop, and this is after some Lightroom filter. So after this video, you'll be able to create this one and just add a filter and you create that one. Alright, this is our lion. I already removed the background from this one. Let's make a comfort smart object. Drag it in our new file. We have to transform it, flip horizontal, like that. Then this will be our ground. Put it in the new file. Little bit bigger, stretch it like that, maybe even bigger. Now let's make the details a little bit better from the ground. So go to filter, camera raw filter, and bring up the texture, maybe even the clarity also. Alright, now let's remove this whole background, create a layer mask of it. So, select the gradient tool, hold down shift, make sure these are black to white, and just make this line the other way. So that's our background, it's gone now. This stone, select the quick selection tool. Convert to smart object and reverse it. Make it. Just turn it around like that. Right, let's make the background black. Brush this a little bit, so make a layer mask, select the general brush, bring the hardness down, bring this a little bit down, and just brush this away so it will be darker at the end. Okay, maybe not that part, but these parts, like that. Alright, let's do some color blending. Floor needs a little bit more red, so let's create a color balance. This is on top of the ground layer. Select this and bring the reds up. You can leave it like that. Just a little bit of red. And let's remove some color from it. This is fine. Let's put this in a folder. Select all the layers from the ground and click on this folder. This is our ground. This is our rock. Let's blend this rock also. Color balance. Select this and it's a little bit like red, yellow. Like that, and also remove some color from it. Right, let's see, maybe we can brush the floor a little bit on this side, just to make it darker. Like that. select this part, copy it, paste it in the background, create a smart object, and move it around a little bit. Something like that. Let's remove some color from it. New saturation. Bring the saturation down. And maybe this part, so it needs to go. So make a mask of it. Just brush a little bit away. This looks fine for now. Alright, so we don't need this anymore. Don't need this. Don't need that. And let's see. Let's do some burn first. Create clipping mask. Edit fill 50% gray. Change the blending mode to overlay. Select the burn tool and let's do some highlights first. So this side will be darker. We need to make it darker. And some shadows. That is better already. Now let's add some curves. Curves, select this. Bring the highlights down. Maybe even the midtones. Get a little bit more contrast. And bring back the lighter parts. Select the general brush. Hardness 0. A little bit up and brush the light parts. Alright, let's change his color a little bit. Color balance, give him a little bit red. Let's create some shadows. Create a new layer underneath the lion. This is our lion. Let's put it in folders. Lion. And grab the general brush, soft round. Bring these down. Make sure this hardness is 0. And just brush. Our light is on this side, so we need our shadows on this side. Start with pause. Maybe even less. Okay, it should have a little shadow underneath this paw. A hard shadow. So, bring the hardness up. Bring these up. And just imagine where he touches the floor. It needs some hard shadow. Same goes for this paw. Just a little line underneath it. Drop the opacity, maybe to this. I can barely see it, but it's a little detail. I think it's important. Maybe make it even darker. Alright, let's make some more shadows on this side. So create a new layer. Make some big shadows. Bring the hardness down. Bring the opacity down. Bring the flow down. And just brush around this area. Him. It's maybe getting too dark now, so we leave these parts lighter, brushes away. Make this part of our line a little bit darker. Create a new layer, curves layer on top of it. Select this again and bring it down. So we have some dark areas. And select the mask of the curves. Zoom in a little bit and select the black one. Let's see, grab a normal brush, soft round. Bring these a little bit down and just brush these parts away on the left side. So we have some lights from here. This needs to be lighter. Maybe also the eye. Like that. This part is also getting some light. Maybe this can stay a little darker. Good. And make sure his face is visible on this side. Can be darker. See, this was before and this is after. Maybe bring it a little bit. The mid-tones, bring these mid-tones down. Drop the opacity a little bit. Let's make some dust in the background. Create a new layer. Select the, I don't know, any fog brush. Just pick some color from the ground. these up. Opacity and flow. Dead. Put it behind him. Just make sure it's something like that. And drop the opacity a little bit. And let's brush the background a little bit darker. So I'll just grab the burn tool. A little bit darker. And let's make another one. Maybe pick another. Let's see what this is. And make a new layer, of course. Let's see, maybe we need some shadow in this area, so let's just duplicate this whole layer of him, make it black, flip it vertical, let's try to stretch it out. Some blur to it. Filter blur. Some blur. And make it dark. Or drop the opacity. So we have a little bit more shadow. Alright, let's put these shadow files in one folder because it's a mess now. And I couldn't find any paw print in the sand, so I'm just gonna use the original one. So just make a selection of it. Copy it. Paste it. Bigger, maybe drop it a little bit, and let's see, make him smaller and also the shadow. So first remove some color from it, room saturation, just like this, and move it down. Then it needs a little bit more like red. And let's brush the edges. So make a layer mask. Grab a general brush. Bring this a little bit down. And brush this. Alright, we need to move him more to the back, so we have to make him smaller. And his shadows. Select both layers with Ctrl and make him smaller. This shadow, stretch it. Now back to the paw print. Better already, and let's do some more brushing, especially on the edges. needs a little bit of shadow here. Underneath his paw. Just gonna brush it with the general brush. Alright, let's make the bottom part darker. Create a gradient. Let's pick radial, reverse, bring it up. Change it to soft light. And for some parts lighter. That is it for this one. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you on the next one.